Let f is homomorphism from g to g bar. If fg is equal to g bar, obviously, then f inverse g is equal to this set. The containing this set contains the element of g such that fx is equal to g. Then this is equal to g times kernel f. So this result we prove first by showing we prove this by showing f inverse g bar contained in g kernel f and g kernel f contained in f inverse g bar. So in two part we show. The first part let some element of this set, let x belong to f inverse g bar, let x belong to f inverse g bar, then what is the definition? Then fx is equal to, this mean fx is equal to g bar. This is the definition of the set, right? Now from here what we see, this is equal to, but from here this is equal to fg. From this part fg I can bring this side. That means what we have proved, we have proved that fx equal to fg, and from here I can write fg inverse fx is equal to identity. Obviously this identity we take from this, because these two elements are from the g bar. Now this give us f of g inverse x is equal to e bar, right? This mean g inverse x belong to kernel f, and from here we can write x belong to g, just multiplying g on both sides, g kernel f. So we started the first part supposing x belong to f inverse g bar. This set we have proved the subset of this. Now the second part. So first part is proved. Now we prove the second part. Okay. Second part. How we prove the second part? We prove second part, that is g kernel f contained in f inverse g bar, right? This thing we have to show. So similarly let some element k belong to kernel f. This mean what we get? We get G K belong to G kernel F because it is coset. This means G K belong to G kernel F because it is coset, right? Now, this means F is homomorphism and this element belong to this. That means, this means we can say GK is equal to some G bar. This means, what is the definition of this? This means, this shows that element of this mean G kernel F contained in this set, contained in F inverse G, right? So the second part was proved. Hence the result.